Yeah, it is. You draw the line just above the figure which is already drawn here. I'm drawing in a normal sketchbook, not taken any particular book like acrylic or watermelon or anything else. And let's complete. Little bit more extension. Okay. Now we take the red color. This thing has to be. Just show you a few of them. For this you can use zero number brush for lines that is thinner, so you can draw it appropriately the specific line. Use a round brush for painting the figure of watermelon. Do the green color with the round brush or zero number or the six number brush, and the rest has to be done by the flat brush, that is outside corners. I'll just show you this few of the watermelons that I have already drawn. Now the middle layer between the green, that is the outer side, and the red watermelon, we had to really paint it, but with light yellow. So let's do with the 6 number brush. Round brush. Okay. Some of the layers can be dotted or just pat it through on the watermelon. To make it look like real watermelon. And once the color dries off, you can paint it in the seeds and just give a rough look by one more layer of that color. And one layer should be just under the layer of the watermelon. You can even draw the lines, just the square lines, to show that the figure, and otherwise draw in any other pencil or sketch pens or anything at all light color, so you can make out and just stands out. The watermelon figure should be visible. Now we would like to not to color the background, but just line it up, for instance. So this is the figure we have drawn, and here it is how it's picturized. I'll just write the name.